many will attempt to enter
and not be strong. So what do you think? Are you strong enough? You're right, that's a trick question. But consider this. Throughout our faith history, beginning with Abraham, it was actually Abram when God called him, and began the revelation that there is only one God, the God of love and goodness. From the very, very beginning, over and over and over again, God calls the most unlikely. So think of it. You remember how old Abram was when the Lord called him? He was 75. He was hitting off the gold tees. 75, when he left everything and made this totally new start. It was a pretty dramatic move. He was an old man. And there was this great promise. You're going to be the father of a great nation. Except there was one little problem. Remember that? His wife was childless. And then when the child finally came along, he was on the brink of being sacrificed. Think about Moses. Moses. The great Moses, the giver of the law, liberator of the people. You remember why he was out in the wilderness tending sheep? Prince of Egypt that he was? He was a fugitive from the law. He had murdered a man. He ran for his life. He went to the boonies. And God called him. You go to Pharaoh and tell him to set my people free. And Moses says, I'm sure he's going to listen to me. Not only that, I have a speech impediment. And over again, the message from the Lord is, I'll be with you. I'll be with you. David. Remember his start? He was just a kid. He came to the camp of the army to bring some food to his brothers. When he got wind of this great challenge from the giant Goliath, he volunteered to go and do battle. Can you imagine the confidence level of the troops of Israel when they realized we're sending this kid out? And he defeated the giant. Over and over again, the young, the old, the weak, the most unlikely get the call. One of my favorite stories is the story of Gideon. You can read about him in the book of Judges, chapter 6 and 7. Now the situation, as was often the situation, was that the people of Israel were under total oppression from other peoples. This time it was the Midianites. And it was so bad that as the story begins, Gideon was threshing wheat inside of a big wine cask so that nobody would see him. Because if the enemy had seen them, they would have come down and either burned or stolen all the grain that he was preparing. So an angel came to Gideon and addressed him something like this. Hail, champion! And Gideon responded something like this. Hail, champion! Liberator of your people. what are you talking about? Do you realize I'm from the lowliest tribe of the nation? And my family? We're nobody. And I'm the least in my father's household. You will be the liberator. Well, Gideon requests some proof, and there's some wild stories and how the proof comes. But he gets this reassurance, and he assembles an army, 32,000 troops. And God says, you got too many guys. You go tell your troops, if they're frightened, go home. 12,000 say, see ya. Now he's down to 10,000. And the Lord says, you got too many guys. So there's another extraordinary process. And he ends up with 300. And in the night, in an incredibly creative ruse, they so terrify the enemy that they begin attacking one another. And Israel is totally dominant then. Incredible. Impossible. Many will seek to enter through that narrow gate, but will not be strong enough. You see, the whole point is none of us is strong enough. Over and over again, we have this message that the Lord chooses not the sleek and the powerful, the mighty and the majestic and the high profile, but the simple and the ordinary, and the handicapped and the broken. Over and over again. Even the story of Mary. How can this be? Oh, the Holy Spirit will come upon you. The power of the Most High will overshadow you. And the holy offspring will be called Son of God. And Mary did not say, oh, now I get it. She simply said, let it be done to me according to your word. In 1897, a French nun died. She was only 24 years old. Her name was Sister Teresa of the Child Jesus and the Holy Ghost. We know her as St. Therese of Lisieux, the little flower. Before she died, her superior, who happened to be her blood sister, directed her to write her life story. And it came in a couple of stages. Tell about growing up, about mommy and daddy. And that book, Story of the Soul, was so inspired with faith world that hands down, she became the most popular saint of the 20th century. And her brilliance, her gift to the church, she was even identified and honored as Doctor of the Church, one of the greatest teachers of the faith throughout the ages. Her wisdom was simply this. Lord, I know how simple and weak I am, and I can't do a darn thing. So, take it away. You do it. I can't. There is a quality called pride. And you know, there's this attitude, have a little pride. school pride. Have some national pride. But the essence of pride is, I can do it. We're better than you are. And the essence of faith is, you can do it. Let me get out of your way. So we have these messages today about discipline. And you're okay. And any discipline is about preparation. In music, physical conditioning, sports, and academics, we push ourselves. We sacrifice what's comfortable for the moment for the bigger picture. Well, hang on to this. Enter through the narrow gate. Do you remember that? Oh, Jesus, will many people be saved? He doesn't answer the question. He usually doesn't. Strive to enter through the narrow gate. For many will attempt and not be strong enough. Here we are. We can't do this. But he can. Take his hand. Follow his lead. Recognize your limitation. Recognize the reason we call him Savior is because we all need one. And he's here to save us from our foolish sense that we can do it ourselves. And God bless us all.